in Area 21. Baron, the Cavs, when you look at that team, put your GM hat on, act like Isaiah when he, you know, was with the Knicks and started the, you know, the Raptors and all that good stuff. What are you thinking before the trade deadline?
I'm looking at my notes here, and, you know, I'm just really looking at the chemistry, you know, and I'm looking at that, the fact that the Cavs has chemistry issues. You know, LeBron is probably the hardest working and the hardest playing player on the team. Where is my energy coming from? And so now, as a GM, I'm looking to replace an energy guy, somebody who's taking up cap space, somebody who's taking up a lot of playing time, but I need to get me another big in there that can dominate. So for me, if I'm the Cavs, I'm looking to move Tristan Thompson. I think that, you know, he's been demoted, he's been downgraded, and, you know, a lot of times when you come off of such a high from a championship and been so relied on, and then your role becomes reduced, you know, it's hard to bounce back, especially for a big guy that's playing the center, that's a power forward in this league. You know, I think that he brought a lot to, you know, he brought a lot to them the year that they won it. He was able to step out, guard Steph on the perimeter. You don't see that anymore. You see DJ Augustine and guys going by him. And so I just kind of think that he's worn out his welcome, and it'd be a great move for Cleveland because it won't disrupt everything, but it'll also give them, they can fill that void with another energy rebounding guy.
Now, Isaiah, Shaq, you guys get ready to put your hat on. I'm going to go first. I think that if I'm the Cavs right now, because it seems like they're in the most trouble, I don't know how this can work out. I didn't talk to my tax guy or nothing like that, but I'm going after DeAndre Jordan. And whether it is trading Tristan Thompson, I know that Jordan necessarily can't score 50, 30 points, but I think he can dunk the ball 7 times a game, especially on alley-oops from LeBron and others. But to me, they need a rim protector. I think if you look back to the Olympics just a few years ago, I don't think the USA team wins the Olympics without DeAndre Jordan, because penetration, they were going past us, and his presence inside really stopped. I think he's that intimidating. And I think with he, LeBron, and others, it'll allow Isaiah, those guys, to score. And I just think him on the East, on that team, would kind of help them clean up in some areas, you know, areas that, you know, you never know. But I'm not the GM. I'm going to leave it to you guys next. Shaq, I'm going to save you for last. Zeke, you've done this before. Out of all the teams, not even the Cavs, what team would you say you got something for them?
No, I'd say DeAndre Jordan.
Okay.
The guy that can come over to the East.
Okay.
And make a difference on any team, whether he joins Cleveland, whether he joins Milwaukee. Similar to what
Milwaukee,
Blake,
ooh.
Similar to what Blake has done in, mm-hmm. in Detroit.
Yeah.
I mean, Cleveland needs some energy. They need some juice. They need some hunger. All these guys have been to the mountaintop. Like Bradley Beal was saying, everybody gets to eat.
Yeah.
All these guys are full.
Yeah.
Not only are they full, but they, you know, they drink and everything
they
else.
Sleepy, yeah, time, come yeah. help. Right.
You know, so
Thanksgiving.
Cleveland needs to get some energy guys. They need to get some thirsty guys. They need to get some DeAndre Jordans. They need to get some Jonathan Simmons type players yeah. to come in there and help LeBron to give him that energy. Because if you're looking for LeBron James to give you the energy burst that they need right now, he doesn't have that. I mean, he's 32, 33 years old, so he's not going to be the carrier for too much longer. So they need to get some guys who can come in and do the dirty work. And DeAndre Jordan is a thirsty guy right now, looking for a championship, and he can make a difference on that team.
Shaq, 10 years ago on this day, you were traded. Don't know if you know.
Traded to?
You were traded to Phoenix. Am I right, underdog? You were traded to Phoenix on this day. Not that it means anything, but being on the anniversary, the people in Phoenix are happy.
I was such a joy to coach.
Yes. So what players like yourself that enjoy, who would you bring in there, you know, to change things around?
You know, I love both you guys. Me and you had great battles. Isaiah, you walked me into the Hall of Fame, but I have to disagree with you guys, because when you're a good team and you're always in contention to win the championship, but you know who the champs are, we're getting ready for the champs. So now, if they bring in DeAndre Jordan, he ain't going to be playing in the fourth quarter, because Golden State, they play small ball. So I would get, agree with you a little bit, I would get another energy player, but I need to find me a bona fide shooter. Because right now we got two shooters that ain't really shooting the ball well. Kyle Korver and J.R. Smith, that like two is supposed to equal one, they don't even equal one yet. I need somebody out there that's a bona fide knockdown shooter, and then maybe get another energy guy, and then, you know, just keep pushing the guys, hey, because right now, it's all about effort. It's like, you know, if you watch some of the highlights, they're not boxing out, they're not talking on the screens, they're not playing with heart, effort, and energy. So once they, you know, lose a couple more times and then start to pick it up, they'll definitely come out the East. But in order for them to compete with the chance, because Golden State going to be in, it's either going to be Houston or Golden State, and all they do is shoot threes. DeAndre Jordan ain't going to be out there, because you know why? Because I wasn't coming out there.
you get to a point where in your career, and we all have been there, where you think you got dead legs, but then you realize, oh, I ain't got no more legs, right? And I think that's where a lot of Cleveland's players are at. They've been to the finals, you know, 3-4 years, and they've been playing a lot of years in long extended minutes, and they just don't seem to have the bounce and the energy to me. It just seems like I'm looking at a lot of guys with dead legs that they think is going to come back, but as we know as older players, right, them hops ain't coming back no more.
Gone.
And then I think a lot of Cleveland's guys got the dead legs.
Well, a lot of Cleveland guys ain't played in the finals. You know what I mean? So, you know, they got a bunch of new guys. So those guys have yet to get to the finals. I think Cleveland, this summer, they prepared themselves for Golden State by going out and getting a lot of guys, small ball, Derrick Rose, IT, Crowder. And what it's doing is it's backfired. So now you minimize J.R. Smith's role. Amon Shumpert, he's been hurt, but he's never really had a role. Kyle Korver is trying to find himself. You bring in Wade, which is another big, high-profile guy, and they all play the same position. You know what I mean? And so I think that's where the lack of energy is coming, is you got 6 or 7 guys crampled up trying to give you energy in 2 spots.
Well, thank you. That messed up my theory then, because I like what you said. You're right, but that messed up my theory then that a Lou Williams can help or a George Hill can help.
Well, that's why I'm taking notes, Chris. You know what I mean?
I'll go with you out there.
Put me up on notes.
Hey, we're a team. Everybody eat, man. Hey, you know,
everybody on pictures of our boss. He ain't working.
Pass the beat.
This is what Baron Davis was doing during the break, drawing pictures of people, but
boss,
we don't care.
Working.
This is what he was doing. When we come back, hey, listen. You don't just walk into the highlight factory. You don't just walk into the highlight factory.